Hey, the new Angular 16 is out, which brings a myriad of cool new features, and one of these features is a new injectable entity called DestroyRef. You can inject this token in any Angular building block like component, service, etc. And there you can register a callback function that will be executed right before this scope is destroyed. All right, for that we already have the ngOnDestroy lifecycle hook. Well, then let's try to figure out what the difference between the ngOnDestroy lifecycle hook and this new provider called DestroyRef. If it is your first time on my channel, my name is Dmytro Mrzecki, and here you can find a lot of unique and advanced Angular tutorials. You can check out them later, but now let's get started and learn more about this new feature called DestroyRef. Indeed, the goal of DestroyRef is the same as for the ngOnDestroy lifecycle hook. They both allow you to execute some piece of logic right before the scope is destroyed. And here, by scope, I mean Angular component, directive, pipe, some service, etc. Also, if it matters to you, pay attention that the ngOnDestroy lifecycle hook is called before the callback which we register for the DestroyRef. Though both of them address the same issue, they solve it different ways. And later in this video, we will focus on those differences and the consequences that come out of them. So the main difference is that the ngOnDestroy lifecycle hook, it is a simple class method that is called by Angular right before the scope is destroyed and executes some cleanup logic. The DestroyRef is a class that is injected via dependency injection, and it executes some cleanup logic inside the corresponding callback, which has to be registered by the onDestroy method. And making DestroyRef injectable makes a big impact on how we reuse this cleanup logic within our application. For example, let's take a very popular pattern to unsubscribe from observable using the takeUntil or RxJS operator along with some subject. So once the component is about to be destroyed, the unsubscribe subject emits a value and in such a way kills the subscription. I think it is pretty much obvious. Most likely we would need to have this logic in many parts of our application, right? So if we want to reuse it, we have to extract this logic into some base class, right? And extend it everywhere where this subject along with ngOnDestroy lifecycle hook is needed. So familiar situation, right? So inheritance, it is like simple to understand, it is very sometimes convenient, it have some disadvantages and limitations. For example, it might require some additional boilerplate because you would need to decorate the base class with directive annotation because you use ngOnDestroy lifecycle hook in the base class, right? Then you might be forced to use the override keyword, again, depending on your TypeScript config. And also you would need to call something like super, then ngOnDestroy in case if you want to perform some additional logic in the derived ngOnDestroy lifecycle hook. Also, inheritance is not the best choice when it comes to flexibility. I think many of you know about that. And composition is more flexible way to organize the code. And DestroyRef provider, along with relatively new inject function, allows you to do that. You can extract the cleanup logic into a separate function. There you have to obviously perform some refactoring because we do not rely on the ngOnDestroy lifecycle hook anymore, but instead we use inject DestroyRef provider. So we have to move the logic from the ngOnDestroy lifecycle hook into a corresponding onDestroy callback, right? And then we just have to return the subject we just configured. Now we can reuse this logic everywhere we would need by just calling this function and using the configured subject as an argument for any takeUntil operator where we would need to kill the subscription when the component or anything else is being destroyed. And also, since I don't use ngOnDestroy lifecycle hook anymore, I can remove implementation of onDestroy interface. And as you can see, it remains working as before. Another feature that ngOnDestroy doesn't have, it is an option to be cleared up, or saying simpler, it can be unregistered. I mean the cleanup function. To do that, you have to assign the function which the onDestroy method returns, and then you can call it at some point in time when the onDestroy callback is not needed. I know it is a little bit artificial example, but it shows perfectly the feature itself. So as you can see, currently after 3 seconds I unregister the cleanup function, and if I destroy the component after 3 seconds, this cleanup function is not being called, but obviously it will be executed if I destroy the component within 3 seconds. But let's move forward. There is one limitation though. Since our custom function uses inject function under the hood, this custom function can be used only within the constructor context, either this way or using it inside the constructor directly. So if you try to use this function, for example, inside the onInit lifecycle hook, you will get a runtime error. Since inject function is encapsulated by our custom function, it might be sometimes hard to figure out which exactly function is wrongly used, because we could have many such custom functions that use inject function under the hood, right? So it is a good practice in such functions that use inject underneath, we have to do an additional check using the assert in injection context helper function, that is checking if the function is used in the proper context. And if it is not, it will throw an error where it is clearly visible which exactly function is used in the wrong place. Okay, but we are a little bit out of track, so let's get back to the topic. This DestroyRef provider opens doors to many other cool features that were introduced with Angular 16. One such feature is the new takeUntilDestroyed RxJS operator that is available since Angular 16, and it comes from a new location called RxJS interop. You just add it somewhere at the end of the pipe operator chain, and that's it. This subscription will be killed right before the component is destroyed. So now let's very quickly check what happens under the hood of this operator, and let's learn how the DestroyRef provider is used in the real life use cases. There you can see some already familiar things actually. For example, if the DestroyRef isn't provided, it is being injected using inject function, and before that it checks if this function, if this operator is used inside the constructor or injection context. After that, a new observable is created that emits void value using the next method, and the unregistered function is returned from this observable as a teardown logic, which means that this function will be executed when the destroyed observable will be completed. After that, it returns the source observable extended with the takeUntil operator, which takes this destroyed observable as an argument. So it means that when the component or anything else is destroyed, the onDestroy callback emits a void value to the stream, takeUntil reacts to it and kills the subscription. And while the subscription is killed, it kills the teardown logic and in such a way unregisters the destroy function. And here is the small note, and you probably noticed that this operator uses inject function underneath, which means that if you initialize your observable outside the constructor context, for example, if you initialize your observable inside ng on init lifecycle hook, then it will not work. You will get an error, right? And to make it work, you have to provide an instance of DestroyRef explicitly as an argument for this RxJS operator. And Obviously, you have to inject this DestroyRef somewhere here above. Alright guys, I hope now you have better understanding of this new feature and how it can be used in real use cases in your Angular applications. Of course, it is not a replacement for ngOnDestroy lifecycle hook. It is just another way to do the same thing, but this way, this approach using DestroyRef provider, it is a bit more flexible. It allows you to create such a nice, reusable and useful utils like take until destroyed RxJS operator and many others. For example, Angular 16 also provides you some new API that allows you to convert observables to signals and vice versa. And for that converter functions, there, DestroyRef is also used under the hood. Alright guys, if you like this video and you like how I explain stuff, then please check out my video courses about Angular. I have some of them, but definitely I would like to highlight the one about advanced Angular forms. This is really massive, in-depth and pragmatic course, and you definitely want to check it out. Link I will leave in the video description. Otherwise, subscribe to my other social media, leave your comments under this video, leave your thoughts, where would you use this new DestroyRef feature, and I wish you a productive week ahead, stay safe, and see you in the next video.